guys, it's Steph. Welcome back to the Cantina. Just realized and saw a video on the GMA YouTube website where Dave Filoni, on May the 4th, did an interview with the guys from GMA talking about the Bad Batch. And in the midst of the interview, he had to talk to two so-called superfans. One we all know has a podcast. He's a former Lucasfilm writer. Pete Fletzer, this is not Pete Fletzer. This guy wants Solo 2 to happen. And this guy, yeah, he would want Solo 2 to happen. Look at him. Yeah, so no, it's not. This movie lost $250 million. Part of the blame is casting this clown, Alden Ehrenreich, who we were told the reason why the movie failed so bad is because it wasn't Harrison Ford. Duh! No shit, really? And, you know, I mean, look at this guy. You know, I believe in the indispensable man, but, I mean, this is what authentic masculinity looks like. This is the thing. And then, of course, Lando, or Pando Lando, which, you know, Lando Calrissian was a ladies' man. I love the look on Carrie's face there. She's like, oh my God, get away. Han's best friend. And this jackass, John Kasdan, basically created Pando Lando out of his ass. Meanwhile, Kathleen Kennedy has 80% of the movie reshot, and it still sucks. The woman's decision-making is incompetent, haphazard, and she has no fucking clue what she's doing. Yes, I dropped the F-bomb. She didn't realize what was going on until it was too late. She didn't watch the dailies. And a lot of her decision-making, I believe, is the fault of Pablo Hidalgo, who talked her into it. The complete 180 opposite of what George Lucas would have done in every instance. You've got Bob Iger really wondering what the hell is going on. You got Bob Chapek going, they lost $250 million in this movie. And of course, Star Wars as a franchise has not paid for itself. I don't care what anyone says. Basically, Pablo Hidalgo has left billions, and I mean multi-billions of dollars, on the table because he needed to do his SJW shit and force SJW shit on Star Wars. And he was also the one who bitched and moaned that the fans didn't like Ehrenreich because Ehrenreich isn't Harrison Ford. Really, dude? Really, you noticed that? Oh my God. Someone give him a cookie. He actually was right about something once in his life. Of course, Alden Ehrenreich isn't Harrison Ford. Alden Ehrenreich is a spoiled brat, rich man's son from L.A. He grew up being Steven Spielberg's daughter's best friend, for crying out loud. Where's the authentic masculinity in growing up being a soft pampered pooch? That's not how you get Han Solo. To get a guy like Han Solo, you need someone that has authentic masculinity, someone who's been there, done that, owned the t-shirt, and Harrison Ford was born for the role. I mean, here he is reading lines with Mark Hamill during Mark Hamill's auditions. He brought what was needed to the role naturally because that's who he is. And I'm sorry, but spoiled brats don't actually create masculine, authentically masculine characters. Harrison Ford was a carpenter. He pulled himself up by his own bootstraps, and he wasn't discovered in Hollywood till later because Hollywood was going towards a more ethnic actor like Richard Dreyfuss and Al Pacino and Robert De Niro. But for Han Solo, it needed a classically handsome, authentically masculine guy that could win the princess's heart and make you believe that he had already lived a life before he met Luke and Obi-Wan. And Harrison Ford, because he had already done that, being an actor that was working in Hollywood but not being successful right away, because Hollywood wasn't looking for an actor like him at the time. And he had to supplement his income through carpentry work. And that's just how his career trajectory went until George Lucas decided he was the perfect guy for the role and Han Solo was born. And part of the charm of the character is that it's Harrison Ford playing him. And if the people that at Lucasfilm were upset at the fans for not liking Ehrenreich, it's only their fault because they cast him in the role, in a role that he didn't belong in. He was not the guy for the part. And that is the straight truth. And people just have to accept it. It's a fact. And it was a mistake to cast him, but it wasn't the only mistake in Solo, A Star Wars Story. She made tons of mistakes, hiring Lord and Miller, firing Lord and Miller too late, this moron opening up his mouth about Pando Lando, much to the chagrin of the fans and Billy Dee Williams. I mean, totally ruined the character. And losing $250 million, not just because people were pissed off about The Last Jedi, but because it was a terrible movie. And to this day, I don't think Iger's seen a way for Star Wars to recover, and Chapek sure as heck doesn't, and he's a well-known penny pincher. He's not going to okay Solo 2, no matter how much bald-headed weirdos with monkeys on their shoulders trying to be Edgar Bergen and Charlie McCarthy want it. But honestly, I don't think money is anything that they're even concerned about or even understand. They like this garbage. I have no idea why. They feel sorry for Alden Ehrenreich. I don't. He never should have even tried out for the part. It's one horrible decision after another, and Disney's never going to make Solo 2. So weirdos who want it, let it go. It's not going to happen. The money's not there, okay? And there's no will to make it. Basically, Solo did nothing more than hurt the character more, okay? And that's the sad part of it. This is a great character, one of the greatest characters in film history that made Harrison Ford a movie star. And single-handedly, Kathleen Kennedy destroyed the character with her shitty decision-making. So it's time for you guys to forget Solo 2. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.